Good afternoon, I'm Pastor Charles Ellis here at Harvest New Life Church. Thank you once again for joining us on our Spreaker show. I know most of you know that it's the second part of our Spreaker show that we're dealing with the seven repositionings of the kingdom. And also on yesterday, I must apologize for those who didn't get a chance to actually make them clear to the actual blog talk show. We had some technical difficulties there, but nevertheless, we're here and we're moving forward with what God has us to do on today. I want you to know and understand that when you come into the Blog Talk Internet Radio Show, you want to go to the HarvestNewLifeChurch.com for those who are coming through the internet phase of the show. You want to go over to Schedules and Services. Midway through the page, you'll see a sign that says Blog Talk Power of the Harvest. Click on that, and that'll bring you right into the studio phase of the show. For those of you coming to the Spreaker Show, it is a podcast. It's not a show that you can actually convert back and forth like you do in Blog Talk Internet Radio. Well, those of you who are continuing on, to be a part of the Blog Talk Internet Radio Show, you can also actually call into the studio itself. The number is 347-627-1074. But I believe we got an exciting show today. We took off a little rocky, kind of a bumpy start on yesterday. We didn't quite get ourselves solidified the way we needed to be solidified. But through all, you know, God is still working. He's still in the midst of everything that's going on. You know, let the music kind of roll with you a little bit. Get yourself in a position to see what the Word of God has to say. We're going to be in the book of Mark. It's going to be in that fourth chapter, around that 26th to 29th verse. And just want you to sit back and hear what the Spirit of the Lord has to say on tonight. I believe God is always speaking. The Bible declares that he who has an ear, let him hear what the Spirit of the Lord has to say to the church. We are decreeing according to the Word of God and the power of the Spirit that it's not a weapon that will be formed against this word on tonight. We're going to speak according to what the kingdom has to say. So as I come back, the next voice you will hear is me actually praying. And let's get ourselves prepared to hear what the Word of God has to say that's coming from the kingdom. Thank you once again for joining us here at Harvest New Life Church Spreaker Show, as well as our Blog Talk Internet Radio Show. We hope you enjoy the Word tonight. Just remember, we love you here at Harvest New Life Church. And we're thankful every time you come in to be a part of the show. Father God, we thank you, we bless you, we honor you on this time that we come before your throne, Lord, to receive that which you have given us from the kingdom. Lord, we know the word has been decreed and has declared according to the Spirit, that we know that no weapon formed against us shall prosper. We don't believe according to this word, Father God, nothing is able to stand against it and nothing shall actually shut it down. Lord, we come against every foul thought and every soothsaying spirit. And Father God, even as we come forth and declare your word from the third heavens, we ask you, Father God, to put your loving arms around us. Let your Holy Spirit begin to fall upon us, Father God. Solidify the minds and ears, Lord, of the listeners, Lord, even as me being a man of God. Let me hear what you have to say through me to come from the kingdom of God, that I may speak to your people in such a way, Lord, that they receive that engrafted word that you so give us each and every day, that you're coming closer, Father God, that we know that the Bible declares and decrees you don't know the time, place, or when you show up. But we believe according to the word of God, according to the power of the Spirit, Father God, you have gave us everything we need according to godliness. And Father God, we thank you as we go forth in this word, Father God. We break every glass ceiling, Father God. We shut off every demonic spirit and every demonic porthole. We loose it by the power and the presence of the Holy Spirit. Lord, we decree the word and we declare it. We cause it to come forth. We know it will not go back void, but it will accomplish all that therein, Father God. These things I speak not of myself, but of the power of the Most High God. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I pray, Lord, amen. And I plead the blood on every word that proceeded out of my mouth on tonight. Well, the Bible declares and decrees as we speak over in the book of Mark chapter 4, starting at the 26th verse, we're going to read in the parts of inclements. And for those of you who know when we study, we don't want to actually go through the scriptures too fast to a point we don't get any clarity or understanding what the Word of God is saying. But it goes on and decrees and declares. We look over in the book of Mark 4:26, it says that, and he said, so the kingdom of God, as if a man should cast seed into the ground. Now let's look at this. You know, this is very strong, because we're dealing in the area of talking about growth. And you know, the word decrees, if you don't plant it, then it can't grow. In other words, that's a law that's in the land. If you plant it, it'll grow. And if the word of God says, you being a man of God, or being a woman of God, wherever you may be, you got to understand according that the word says over in the book of John. It talks about in John 15, it talks about the true vine, and I'm the vine dresser. It talks about the branches that bear fruit. And every branch that doesn't bear fruit, he casts into the fire. God has created you to be a part. He designed and engineered you to be, that you bring the word into the land. Now we understand that the word of book of Amos 3:7 said the word doesn't come into the land unless it's revealed through the prophet. That is true. But we got to understand one thing. God has designed and engineered you to be that very little God. To be able to come into the earth, to understand and realize that there's a gift also in you. That other words, when you look at this word of God and you think about it in the practical sense, or just a layman's sense, just thinking about anything. And most of you who know me, I always use different sports events because of being a collegiate sport player and a little bit of time I spent doing some NFL workouts. You want to understand that a team cannot move toward its goal unless everybody on the team plays their role, whether it be on a defense or whether it be on an offense. Anytime there's a breakdown in communication from the leadership, which heads off that team, you're always going to have some discrepancy in the process of moving forward. So what you hear me saying here is that the word of God is designed, even when you take it back to the book of Jeremiah. You look at Jeremiah 1:5, it said, before I formed you, I knew you. And when he said he knew you, that means he gave you the gift. Before you was knitted together in your mother's womb, he declared that you would be a king before the nation. When I say a king before the nation, he's giving you the power. According to Luke 10:19, I gave you power. With the gift that's in you, you had ability, according to Romans 4:17, to call things. We're talking about growth. We're talking about the more you come forth with God's word, the more you empower yourself, the more you allow the seed to grow in you, to branch out those gifts that are in you. Whatever it may be, God will give you more in your area, in your season, because he know you're responsible. You know, it talks about how we got to be diligent as servants over that what God has put in our hands. Well, God has given you a gift. He didn't want you to use your gift prodigally. He didn't want you to do like the prodigal son. He didn't want you to waste what he's given unto you. You know, the word of God talks about the prodigal son, how he wanted his half, and he went out and he splurged it, and he lost everything he had, but he came back to Christ. But in this instant, God is giving you a heads up that you don't have to go out and splurge, or you don't have to fall short, and you don't have to fall down. And even though we all, according to Romans 3:23, we all have fallen short. But what I'm simply saying is the day you hear the word of God, the day you hear God's voice, you know, hearken not your heart. You know, you got to decide what you are. You know, you got to know that God has designed and engineered you to grow. You're designed to be a spectacle of a representation of the kingdom. And once you put on that garment, God is looking toward you to be able to understand how you are to solidify yourself in gathering the harvest. The word of God says the harvest is truly great, but the laborers are few. God is calling you to be a servant and a laborer. Everybody wants to be a leader, but let me tell you something. Everybody can't lead. You got to have, in other words, you can't have all chiefs and no Indians. God is specifically designed and engineered, and he's put people in position according to Ephesians 4:11, the fivefold. For those men of God has been leaders in the ministry to be able to head off the work that God has done, and they have been taught and designed to make you disciples, that what's in you is already been empowered, that when you go out and speak, God has given you the ability to be able to understand that you are a little G. Remember, the word of God says that greater than he that is in you than he that is in the world. In other words, I put it just like this. I make it plain. God said that you got a big old Jesus living on the inside of you. In other words, according to Jeremiah 32:17, he said there's nothing too hard for you to do. And whether you laying hands on people to heal them, whether you're actually going against some oppositions in your life, whether you're going with some obstacles around you, God has given you the ability, according to the Abrahamic covenant, according to Romans 4 and 17. You got the ability to call things that be not, though, if you were. Now, let me say something here, because I want you to understand what God has given you has been a man of power and a man or woman of grace. Now, he says it like this according to the book of Ephesians. He says, I've given you the ability to call things that's out of existence back into existence. In other words, when we spoke out on yesterday, we talk about the repositioning yourself in the kingdom of God. And how you reposition yourself is to be able to line up according to what the scripture says. And we understand and realize in the kingdom of God, God is calling you to be more powerful than you can even imagine or even think of. God said, I gave you everything you need. I'm not going to give you any more faith. I'm not going to give you more wisdom. I'm not going to give you more anything, because I already designed you and engineered you, that what's in you has got the ability to grow. So when the word of God decrees and declares, and it says in the book of Mark 4 and 26, he said, so the kingdom of God, as if a man sowed or a man cast seed into the ground. Look at what he's saying. In other words, responsibly, a believer is to spread the gospel. This is what you're designed to do. The word of God says, according to Jeremiah 1 and 5, it's already in you. Before you was knitted together in your mother's womb, God has already given you that what you need to play your role on this earth. You can't nobody give it to you. A prophet can't give it to you. Can't nobody speak it into you. They can identify what's in you through the spirit, because John 4:24 says that spirits recognize spirits. Now, when you come to an area of discerning the word of God, you need to understand that it's something that's in you. And when you're looking for that, what God has put in you, and you seem to be in the valley of the shadows of death, and you seem to be working in wilderness, God says, call on him. He said, if any man lack wisdom, let him ask. What is he saying? I will water that seed that I already put in you. I've designed you. I've engineered you to flourish. I've designed you to be a workmanship of my counsel. I've designed you to be an ambassador. And we understand what an ambassador is. That means God has given you the power in a foreign country. Am I speaking? That when you understand and realize, he said, I've given you power. As a matter of fact, the book of Ephesians 1 and 21 says it like this. He says, far above all principalities and power in dominion. He says, they ain't just named only in this world, but everything that's to come. In other words, everything that's got an obstacle to try to come against you, God said, I already headed off through what I put in you. You got the ability to speak, declare, and decree. And no one understands that I've created you as an instrument, a fine representation of me. That when you dig down in your spirit and you realize and understand, when you prostrate yourself before me, I will by no means turn you away. We think about the book of Daniel, not forsaking the book of Mark, and the word of God decrees and declares, and you hear me probably say this quite a bit on the course of my study, because it's such a relevant and such a powerful statement that's been made. In the book of Psalms 84 and B39, the word of God, you can turn there, you can look at it, but I'm going to show you something for the sake of time. David said in the book of Psalms 89 and 34 that his covenants he will not alter. Now, I may not be getting it as you need to get it in terms of word for word, but he talks about that his covenants he will not alter. Know the words that goes out of his mouth. And you go on down to the 35th verse, he said, David swore. He said, I swore by his word. He swore by his word that everything Christ has spoken into him. Matter of fact, you know, let's creep over there for a second here. And let's look at something, because we don't want to get off track to what we're speaking about here. We're talking about the growth of the kingdom of God. And we want to flip ourselves over to the book of Psalms 89 and 34. Just for a second, I'm going to turn over there with you. I want to get some understanding out of this, because if you're going to bring a word, you want to bring it with clarity, you want to bring it with understanding, you want to bring it so layman that a babe can understand it. I don't need to give you a whole lot of theological words and a bunch of whole lot of Hebrew words. I need to give you the layman. See, this is a problem we have in the house of God today. Look, make it plain. The Bible says make it plain.